was the night after Christmas, and all through the trailer, the beer had gone flat and the pizza was staler. The tube socks hung empty, no candy or toys, and I was camped out in my old lazy boy. The kids, they weren't talking to me or my wife. The worst Christmas, they said, they had had in their life. Well, my wife couldn't argue and neither could I, so I watched TV and my wife, she just cried. When out in the yard, the dogs started barking, I stood up and looked and I saw Sheriff Larkin. He yelled, "Roy, I am sworn to uphold the laws, and I got a complaint here from a feller named Claus." "Claus? I don't know nobody named Claus, and you ain't taking me in without probable cause." Then the sheriff, he said, "The man was shot at last night." I said, "Well, that might have been me. Just what's he look like?" "Well, he's a jolly old feller with a big beer gut belly that shakes when he laughs like a bowl full of jelly. He sports a long beard and a nose like a cherry." I said, "Sheriff, that sounds like my wife's sister, Sherry." "It's no time for jokes, Roy," the sheriff, he said. "The man I'm describing is dressed all in red. I'm here for the truth now. It's time to come clean. Tell me what you've done and tell me what you've seen." Well, I started to lie, then I thought, what the hell? Wouldn't be the first time I'd spent New Year's in jail. I said, "Sheriff, it happened last night about 10, and I thought that my wife had been drinking again. When she walked in from work, she was white as a ghost. I thought maybe she'd seen one of them UFOs. But she said a bunch of deer had just flown over her head and stopped on the roof of our good neighbor Red. Well, I ran out to look, and the sight made me shudder. A freezer full of venison standing right on Red's gutter. Well, my hands were a-shaking as I grabbed my gun. When out of Red's chimney this feller did run, and slung on his back was a bag overflowing. I thought he'd stolen Red's stuff while old Red was out bowling. So I yelled, "Drop it, fat boy, hands up in the air." But he went about his business like he hadn't a care. So I popped a warning shot over his head. Well, he dropped that bag and he jumped in that sled. And as he flew off, I heard him extort, "That's assault with intent, Roy. I'll see you in court." Sheriff, I'll tell you this. You put a subpoena on me, I ain't gonna show up. I'll hole up in the cellar. You'll never root me out of there. So why don't say we just forget all this? Look, we've known each other a long time. You just turn the car off, come in. We'll watch wrestling, eat some Easter Bunny stew, and talk about how to catch that tooth fairy.